Good day, everyone. Today we celebrate the feast of the fourth Sunday of Easter, also known as Good Shepherd Sunday, And on this day, and as our parish was here gathered together, we would also be celebrating a teen mass. So I'd like to welcome in a special way all of our young people who might be watching our liturgy today and participating. Certainly, it's good for us, even though we are separated in a variety of different places, to realize that we are united by the Holy Spirit. And it is that in that spirit that we worship our God. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. My brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy. You came to call sinners. Christ, have mercy. You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. We praise you, we bless you, we adore you, we glorify you, we give thanks for your great glory, Lord God, heavenly King. O God, almighty Father, glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth. Jesus Christ, only begotten Son, Lord God, Lamb of God, Son of the Father, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. You take away the sins of the world, receive our prayer. You are seated at the right hand of the Father. Have mercy on us. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest. And on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill. For you alone are the Holy One, you alone are the Lord, you alone are the Most High, Jesus Christ. With the glory of God the Father. Glory to God, glory to God, glory to God in the highest, and on earth, peace on earth, peace to people of goodwill.
Let us pray. Almighty ever-living God, lead us to a share in the joys of heaven, so that the humble flock may reach where the brave shepherd has gone before, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. Then Peter stood up with the 11, raised his voice, and proclaimed, "Let the whole house of Israel know for certain that God has made both Lord and Christ this Jesus whom you crucified." Now when they heard this, they were cut to the heart, and they asked Peter and the other apostles, "What are we to do, my brothers?" Peter said to them, "Repent and be baptized, every one of you, in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of your sins, and you will receive the gift of the Holy Spirit. For the promise is made to you and to your children and to all those far off, whomever the Lord our God will call." He testified with many other arguments and was exhorting them, "Save yourselves from this corrupt generation." Those who accepted his message were baptized, and about 3,000 persons were added that day. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Shepherd me, O God.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Beloved, if you are patient when you suffer for doing what is good, this is a grace before God. For to this you have been called, because Christ also suffered for you, leaving you an example that you should follow in his footsteps. He committed no sin, and no deceit was found in his mouth. When he was insulted, he returned no insult. When he suffered, he did not threaten. Instead, he handed himself over to the one who judges justly. He himself bore our sins in his body upon the cross, so that, free from sin, we might live for righteousness. By his wounds you have been healed. For you had gone astray like sheep, but you have now returned to the shepherd and guardian of your souls. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, whoever does not enter a sheepfold through the gate, but climbs over elsewhere, is a thief and a robber. But whoever enters through the gate is the shepherd of the sheep. The gatekeeper opens it for him, and the sheep hear his voice. As the shepherd calls each his own sheep by name and leads them out. When he has driven them all his own, he walks ahead of them, and the sheep follow him because they recognize his voice. But they will not follow a stranger. They will run away from him because they do not recognize the voice of strangers." Although Jesus used this figure of speech, the Pharisees did not realize what he was trying to tell them. So Jesus again said, "Amen, amen, I say to you, I am the gate for the sheep. All who came before me are thieves and robbers, but the sheep did not listen to them. I am the gate. Whoever enters through me will be saved, and will come in and go out and find pasture. A thief comes only to steal and slaughter and destroy. I came so that they might have life and have it more abundantly." The Gospel of the Lord. The image of the shepherd has been used by people of faith for a long time to describe God's care for his people. The people of Israel saw God as the one who shepherded them. He shepherded them out of Egypt. He defended them against their enemies. He was the one who would ultimately give them rest. Certainly we know that King David, when he was writing the psalm that we sang today, knew that God was the shepherd. He was the true shepherd who was going to care for him. Certainly Jesus picked up on that same image when he spoke about himself. He saw himself as being a shepherd, one who would care for the people, and one who would also be somebody who would care for them even though they would have great difficulty. Now, the shepherd in Jesus' day was not this kind of shepherd who was wearing nice clothes with a nice, clean face. This was a rough character who was the shepherd, somebody who would really defend the sheep, who would care for them. And so we know that he would have to occasionally fight off wild animals. He would occasionally have to fight off other people who would try to steal the sheep. He might have to sometimes take the sheep that have fallen into a hole and pull them out of it. So that shepherd really cared for the sheep in a very strange way, in a very careful way. But certainly we know that Jesus actually is in some sense also our shepherd, and in many ways he does the same kinds of things for us spiritually. He fights off the evil one. He saves us from being stolen from the flock, and he keeps us from danger. Certainly we know, as the gospel tells us today, Jesus, besides being a shepherd, is also a sheep gate. And that might be something strange that we would use that term, but actually in Jesus' day, a shepherd literally would sleep across the opening of a corral, you might say, where the sheep were kept. In other words, it was the shepherd himself who was the gate for the sheep. And so in many ways, just as Jesus is the gate for us all to eternal life, certainly we know that the shepherd in those days was also a gate, somebody who would keep the sheep in, who would make sure that nobody who did not belong there would try to get in. Jesus many times used this image about himself. He said, "I am the good shepherd." He used the image of the shepherd who would leave the 99 and go after the one that was lost. That's the kind of shepherd that Jesus is for all of us. That's what we celebrate today. Today also, as a church, we remember the Vocation Sunday. This is a day when the church asks us to try as best we can to pray in our own life and to encourage vocations to the priesthood and religious life. In many ways, we need people who are going to follow the image of Jesus, who are going to guide people and lead them along the way to eternal life. Certainly we know these people are gates to the presence of God, defenders of us from the evil, and guide us to the Father. Let us pray then that the Lord will send many more people who will guide us and lead us in the church and ultimately follow the example of the Good Shepherd. Let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord, Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy, Catholic, and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. The Good Shepherd does not allow the sheep to wander in harm's way. Knowing we are heard, let us pray with confidence. For the Lord's flock and its pastors, that they always reflect the Lord's deep love, we pray to the Lord. For an increase of vocations to the priesthood and religious life, especially in our diocese, we pray to the Lord. For the people of every nation, that they live their lives with courage and find true peace, we pray to the Lord. For those who feel lost and abandoned, that they enjoy the nurturing love and support of the Good Shepherd, we pray to the Lord. For the members of this assembly, that we and all those we love shepherd one another well, we pray to the Lord. For our bishop-elect, Kevin Sweeney, that the Holy Spirit will guide him as he prepares to lead our diocese, We pray to the Lord. For those who are ill and listed in our Book of the Sick, that they receive the healing power of Christ, we pray to the Lord. For those who have died, especially Josephine and Paul Davitt Sr., Daphne and Edward Puchalowski, Jim Tomlinson, and Thomas Cole, and also the recently deceased Kathleen Veda, that they have eternal life in Christ, we pray to the Lord. O Mary, you always shine on our path as a sign of salvation and of hope. We entrust ourselves to you, health of the sick, who at the cross took part in Jesus' pain, keeping your faith firm. You know what we need, and we are sure that you will provide, so that as in Cana of Galilee, we may return to joy and to feasting after this time of trial. Help us, Mother of Divine Love, to conform to the will of the Father and to do as we are told by Jesus, who has taken upon himself our sufferings and carried our sorrows, to lead us through the cross to the joy of the resurrection. Under your protection, we seek refuge, Holy Mother of God. Do not disdain the entreaties of those who are in trial, but deliver us from every danger, O glorious and blessed Virgin. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen.
My nets and labor.
other shore.
Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Almighty Father. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these paschal mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the cause of our unending joy. Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time, above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exults in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Arthur, our Bishop, and Kevin, our Bishop-elect, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Elizabeth Ann Seton, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen, amen, amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us now offer each other a sign of peace. Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be.
Shall come.
Let us together pray the Ignite Prayer. Heavenly Father, pour forth your Holy Spirit to inspire our parish community. Stir in our souls the desire to renew our faith and deepen our relationship with your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Ignite us that we might truly hear, believe, and live the good news. Grant us the confidence to proclaim your message to others. Strengthen us that we might go forth and witness to the gospel in our everyday lives. Sanctify our words and actions. God our Father, we pray that through the Holy Spirit, we might begin to make all things new as we seek to transform our parish. We pray that we might renew our commitment to your mandate to minister to one another. We pray that we might be restored to the vitality of our baptism as we accept our mission to go out and witness to the saving grace of your Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever. Amen. Let us pray. Look upon your flock, kind shepherd, and be pleased to settle in eternal pastures the sheep you have redeemed by the precious blood of your Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated. First of all, I would like to thank our young people for the music and for the readings today. Certainly, it was important for us to have a variety of different people ministering in our church, and we're happy that you are here with us today. Offerings can be made once again through Faith Direct, and they can be mailed into our office. The Sunday liturgy is going to be streamed every Saturday evening at 5:00, and it will be later available on the website for the rest of the weekend. We are always looking for better ways to communicate with our parishioners. The current crisis we find ourselves in forced all churches to make changes quickly in their mass schedules and other parish activities. Spreading the word on these changes was challenging. Just prior to the crisis, we were testing a tool called Flocknote. We were planning to introduce it to you one weekend after all the masses, but because of the quarantine, we will be mailing all parishioners information on Flocknote and instructions on how to sign up. While signing up is optional, we strongly suggest that you do so in order to receive timely information from us. You can unsubscribe at any time if you choose to. Additional information can be found on our website. I think it's interesting that on Good Shepherd Sunday, we introduce Flocknotes. Have a good week, everyone. The Lord be with you. Bow down for the blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may the blessing of Almighty God, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit come upon you and remain with you forever. Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Sun will rise, Alleluia is our song. What peace we have, even in this wounded world, where the battle rages on. We will not fear, for we know who heals our souls. Alleluia is our song. Alleluia, Alleluia, is risen over us.